take your opposable thumb, make that okay sign, and give it a circle. So let's go ahead and wish our friends a fabulous Friday. I'm so glad you're here. And a one, and a two, and a three. Fabulous Friday, grown-ups. It's so fabulous to see you, kiddos. We're so happy you joined us, readers. We're glad you came to read. Yay! That's right, because today we are going to be doing some singing partner reading. Yes, that's right. That's producer Nate and I, and we're going to be reading about all the fun things that you can see down by the bay. Did you see what I just did? That's right. This is going to be a singing music book, and it's called Down by the Bay. Can you do that? Down, and then we're going to say this is bay, like the ocean, like the waves from the ocean into the bay. That's why I've got a dolphin on my head. Miss Kim has a dolphin on her head. This is the sign for dolphin. That's right. It's also the sign for whale. See, this is your D. Dolphin making the diving waves. This is a W. Remember this one because we're going to be using this one today. This is for whale. So it's the same, isn't it? It's totally the same. Also, what is mom? Take your opposable thumb, kitty chin. That's right. Because we're going to hear mommy say a lot of words. We also have the word watermelon. Remember that one? This is water. It's your number three, which is also a W. Fun fact, just like in whale. Tapping your chin twice, water, and then take your ring finger on your hand, melon. That's right. And then there will be all sorts of different animals in this book, animals that we see down by the bay. We're going to see that whale. We're going to see a moose. See the antlers? We're going to see a llama. This is one of my favorite signs. So you're going to make a little llama face, and that llama is going in front of your face like this. Llama. Llama. And then we're also going to see a bear. And then we're also going to see a goose. And then, of course, we're going to see that bay. A bay is a big body of water that's right next to the ocean. And chances are it's because it's the ocean water, that water is salty, or as my son Max would say when he was young, Mom, this water tastes like French fries. That's right. That's a fun fact for you. So, without further ado, we need to let Storytime Magic in the room, but we need someone to help us with that. Who could that be? It's my assistant, my sidekick, my partner, my producer, my camera guy, my son, my kid, my Nate, producer Nate. Come on over, producer Nate. Let's see what son producer Nate says. I'm wondering if it's a sea animal like Miss Kim. There he is. Oh, producer Nate, what does he have on his head? Producer Nate has a narwhal on his head. Producer Nate has a narwhal on his head. Producer Nate has a narwhal on his head. I wonder if we'll see it down by the bay. That's right. All right, so yes, down by the bay is our story. So let's go ahead and let Storytime Magic into the room. Now, producer Nate, would you and your narwhal hat like to do the honors? Let's do it together as a team. And a one, and a two, and a three. It is story time right now. Yay, look what he's doing. He's using his finny fin fin. Story time, yay. Story time, yay. It is story time right now. Yay, let's read our book. That's right, thank you, narwhal. Producer Nate. Did you know this fun fact? I really wanted to wear the narwhal hat today, but Nate said no, it's his narwhal hat, it's very special.
Yeah, and I got it for Christmas.
And you got it for Christmas, and it was special. So, of course, I went to my dolphin hat, which is equally fabulous, in my opinion. Well, this is a story called Down by the Bay. How do we do that with our jazz hands? Down by the Bay. That's right, down by the bay. And this is a singing book that producer Nate and I are going to be partner singing today. And again, let's take a look at the title page. I love this. You see our two friends, and they're eating what?
Watermelon.
That's right. Because down by the bay is where the watermelons grow.
Watermelon.
All right, without further ado, let's go ahead and sing. Down by the bay, down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Down back to my house, my home, I dare not go. For if I did, my mother would say. And what did she say? Did you ever see a goose kissing a moose down by the bay? Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother would say. Did you ever see a whale with a polka dot tail down by the bay? Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother would say. Did you ever see a fly wearing a tie down by the bay? Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother would say. What did she say? Did you ever see a bear combing his hair down by the bay? Look at him. He's combing his hair and he's got a mirror. He's making sure that he looks very nice. Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother would say. What would she say? Did you ever see, break out those llamas, a bunch of llamas eating their pajamas down by the bay? Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother would say. What did she see? Wait for it. Did you ever have a time when you couldn't make a rhyme down by the bay? I don't know if that's ever happened to me. Have ever not been able to make a rhyme? That's kind of like my superpower.
You can always make the perfect rhyme.
So, have you ever seen Miss Kim taking a swim down by the bay? How about
have you ever seen producer Nate eating fish bait
down by the bay? Or would we ever see producer Nate eating a fat steak?
No,
I don't think so. He's a vegetarian. Would we ever see Miss Kim
taking a swim?
Very good. One. Have you ever seen Miss Kim in a big gym?
Down by the bay.
Have you ever seen producer Nate eating some cake?
Have you ever seen producer Nate on a date?
Down by the bay.
Which will probably never happen.
I know.
Well, maybe not. We'll see.
All right, we're going to believe it is time for us to say goodbye to all of our friends. Stay tuned on Marvelous Monday for another book from our miscellaneous book of the box. Yay. All right, let's go ahead to the Rapparito Manor because thank producer Nate. Producer Nate is going to swim on over to his camera stuff and take a big splash.
Let me redo that.
All right, he's going to do a reverse.
snake this way. So, let's go ahead, without further ado, say goodbye to all of our friends. And one, and two, and three. Goodbye, grown-ups. It was so fabulous to see you, kiddos. We're so happy you joined us, readers. We're glad you came to read. Yay! All right, friends, I am so grateful that you came and joined us today for Miss Kim's Storytime. And remember, this is our 90th video as of today. And we post all of those videos onto our Miss Kim Storytime YouTube channel. And you can go on and you can watch any video from way back in March when we started doing this wonderful, wonderful collaboration. So I hope I see you over on that platform and subscribe. Oh, you'll get notices about new videos, all sorts of fun things. So check that out. All right. Well, I hope you'll have a fabulous weekend and stay happy and healthy and positive. And we hope to see you on Marvelous Monday. All right, well, take care, and know, friends, you are loved, you are appreciated, and you are needed to make this world a beautiful place. Thank you for being you. Bye.